house. I'm driving right now, and I can't text and drive, so I just want to talk about this because you keep reaching out to me at very random times, and I'm working very long hours, and I'm sure you are too.
Yeah, so am I. So
yeah, I'm sure you are, but here's the deal. So when you leave a job the way you left the job, we mail out the paycheck. And you need also to get reimbursed for that $9. And I asked you at the beginning of the week for your address so I could fill out that information for you. And I don't have that information. So I need you to give it to me again. And then I will send you your paycheck in the mail today. And you should get it by Saturday. I mean, it's Thursday and it's sure, you know, a day in the mail or whatever. I don't know when I'm going to be at the warehouse again. And I keep all of my accounting information, all the paychecks, all the PC, everything on my person because I don't trust leaving anything at the warehouse.
Uh-huh.
Because people come and go. So this is just the way that I keep. It's more not a regular job. You can't just drop by. Like, we don't have normal office hours. So I just need a heads up if you are planning on picking up your paycheck. You never told me you were going to do that.
I'm so, planning on it, but I just happen to be up here. For reasons you don't need to know, and I'm just right down the street, so.
Yeah, I'm sorry, I'm just not there. Yeah, and I don't need personal information. I'm trying to get this to you. I mean, in order for me to help you out, I just need you to give me your address. That's all.
So none of the paperwork that I filled out and all of the information I filled out with accounting is.
Yes, exactly, and I'm not accounting, so I don't have that info. They just need to put it. A stamp on it and to get that information from you because I'm not in that office. I'm on set. So if you don't want to give it to me, that's fine. I'll just have to wait till I get to accounting later. That's why I've been waiting to send it because I don't have that information. This does not mean to be difficult or negative. This is just the way we do things. And I'm sorry that it's not, you know.
I'm just confused because I literally, not even an hour ago, spoke to somebody who.
I don't know who you spoke to.
Let me finish my sentence. I spoke to somebody less than an hour ago who worked in the art department and literally came in and picked up a check.
I don't know who you're talking about, but they didn't work for me, so I don't know.
Right, because he was there before you came on.
He didn't pick it up from our office is all I'm saying. I'm just telling you that I have your check on my person and I'm not at the warehouse. That's all. This is not complex. Like, that's for real. This is what it is. So I don't know what the argument is here. So we can decide on the time for you to come to the warehouse. I just don't know when that is yet. Or I can mail it to you. That's all. That's what I got for you.
Huh. Okay. Well, I will, I guess I'll figure it out since I can't. You know, meet
well,
anywhere.
What would you like me to do? Do you want me to put it in the mail, or do you want to pick it up for me? Can you just tell me that much? That way,
It would be amazing if I could just come pick it up, since I've got bills today too, and it's like a week behind actually getting it. So
you're not a week behind getting it. When you leave a job, it gets mailed to you, and the accountants were not going to mail it to you themselves, which is not really standard, but that's the way this movie goes. So they've made me responsible for mailing it, and I've been working 20-hour days. So I've just been waiting for that information from you. That's all. This is not like. Again, this doesn't need to be a conflict.
No, it doesn't, but every time I try and contact you, I get my head bit off. So
that's not true, Mary. Not true at all. And I gotta go now, so I'm gonna check it at the warehouse.
Yeah, all right.